After the two straight losses, did the bye week, now what you see a lot today, come at a good time?
I think so. I think it gave us a chance to just sit back and reflect and get our minds right and heal up some injuries and just get ready to go. Sitting back and watching the other teams in the West play well, I think it made us hungrier, and we're just ready to go.
Did you stay around town? Because in the past you stayed around.
Yep, I was here.
So what did you do during this weekend?
Just put in the work. Just get ready for Toronto, watch the previous games we had, see what we can improve on, see what, the newer guys, see what they did well, and, try to take advantage of their strengths. And, I think we have a good game plan going in, and, we'll be ready to go.
What did you learn during the bye week about this team?
I just learned how to use what guys in certain situations and what each guy is, their strengths and weaknesses. Just gave me a chance to really sit down and study our offense, our receivers, our backs, and just see how we can use them.
How is this year's bye week different than previous years?
I think just the situation we're in, one, as far as the new pieces we have on offense, it was more of a study session for me, more of just learning more about our players and what they do well.
How about coming back to a closed practice? Does that make a difference to you, or is it just us complaining about some?
I didn't know it was closed, so I didn't pay it any attention. No.
That's a good thing, I guess.
Well, I mean, I just thought we were doing media in the locker room. I didn't know. I don't usually look up in the stands after, during practice, so I honestly, I didn't know.
What are your thoughts about Will Ford here?
I don't know much, about him, but, I know he can run, and he did some great things for Winnipeg last year. Even though they struggled, he was a bright spot in their offense and on special teams. So I know he's an explosive player, and, I think he'll be able to help us.
What are your thoughts about this running back carousel, if you want to call it that? What are your thoughts about that as a quarterback and some consistency?
Of course you want consistency back there. You want to get comfortable with the guy. It took me a couple of years to get comfortable with Corey. So it's not an easy process, but it's out of my hands. I just call the plays that come to me and just try to execute them the best way I can. So, you got to ask Coach about that.
When you look at the film and the receivers, is it you trust them more seeing where they are, or trust yourself, or trust your reads more after
what? I don't even think it's about that. I just think it's putting guys in position to do what they do best. With camp being so short, and I didn't have a lot of reps with all of those guys, just seeing them in game type situations, it allows you to realize what they do. So we're going to be moving guys around a little bit and putting them in positions where they can be successful.
Does it send a message when a guy like Hugh Charles gets cut a week after he fumbled and was benched?
I don't know. I don't read into that. I think Brendan and J.O. and Coach Shame, they have a plan, and I believe in that plan. So, it's sad to see a guy like Hugh go. He was such a great teammate, a great guy, but, my job is to believe in whatever personnel decisions we make.
Do you think this offense is a little tight right now?
No, not at all.
It's early in the season, but, how important is maybe your leadership, making sure nobody gets negative after a couple losses?
I've been here a long time now, and we've suffered numerous losing streaks with me at quarterback. And, it's all about staying positive and knowing about the big picture, and that's about, winning a championship. You can't win a championship in week one or week 10. You have to make sure you take the proper steps during the journey to get there. So that's my message. Just don't get down after a loss or two. It's going to happen. Teams they get paid too. They can play ball. So, we just have to make sure we stay focused and bounce back.
You mentioned you saw some things that you need to, or the offense needs to improve on. What was the main thing that really resonated with you?
I don't know if I said things we needed to improve on. I just said we need to make sure we, move guys around and put them in spots where they, are comfortable and where they can use their strengths.